Okay guys, what is up? Welcome back into the channel, guys. Today we're going to be talking about Cam Akers. So let's get into the video, guys. Like I said, we're going to be talking about Cam Akers, running back for the Rams. Last year was his rookie season. He's going into year two with us. He led the team in rushing yards with 625 yards in the regular season. And then the playoffs, he had 221 yards. And actually, in the regular season, he had 625. He led the team. But Darrell Henderson Jr. had 624. So, Akers actually only got it by 1 yard. So, it's a pretty close battle there, and Malcolm Brown wasn't that far off of that 600 mark either, so they're all around that 500-600 mark. But I think he's going to do better this year. I think he's ready to step up and really take that starting running back position. Obviously, last year he was kind of starting running back position, but also, Darrell Henderson Jr. and Malcolm Brown also got a good amount of snaps there. So, kind of went around, but I feel like last year kind of prepared him for this year. I think he's going to do better this year than he did last year. Obviously, with Malcolm Brown leaving, that leaves kind of a hole in the running back group. So, I think he's ready to step up and really take the starting running back position. And I think he's going to be good at it this year. I think you're going to see him probably with around 1,000 rushing yards this season. And I know that's a decent amount, but not too much. But if you look at the receivers we have, that's a lot with the receivers we have. But the thing is, we can run the ball or pass it. Like, we're stacked on offense and defense, really. I think you're going to see him probably have 800 to 1,000 yard season. I think he's going to get 800 yards, at least 800 yards, I feel like. I feel like he'll get at least 800, probably more 900 to 1,000 yards, but I'm not too sure. But I feel at least 800 yards. If he doesn't get that, then something big's got to happen to him. I feel like he should get there, but I feel like he's going to progress into this season, you know. He's going to be better than he was last season. I feel like we're going to be able to rely on him a little more now since he's in year two. I think we'll be able to rely on him a little bit more than last year. And don't get me wrong, he was reliable last year, but this year he kind of is more familiar with the team and Sean McVay's playbook. So I feel like it's just going to be a little better this year. You know, he's more familiar with the team, most of the team around him that hasn't changed. And you know, he's more familiar with the Sean McVay's playbook. So I feel like that's also going to play a role in it. I think the main thing for him is going to be the change at quarterback. I don't think it's going to affect him that much, though. I feel like it might affect him a little bit, but I don't think it'll affect him that much. You probably got used to having Goff passing the ball, but now we're changing to Stafford, which I think was a good move for the team. But I think he'll get used to it pretty quick, you know, with the all the practices they got right now and OTAs. So the first open practice was a couple days ago. Right. Friday, yeah, I think, right? Yeah, it was a couple days ago. First open practice of the season. But I think this year he's really ready to step up. And I think Darrell Henderson Jr. is also ready to step up. But I think Akers is ready to step up. And I think he might have a battle on his hands for the starting running back position with Henderson. But I honestly think it's going to go to Akers. Now, I could be wrong on this. Henderson's a nice, solid running back, just like Akers. but I feel like he's gonna go to Akers as this with the starting position, but not sure on that. But you know, I think it's gonna be Akers with the starting position. Nothing's actually set in stone on whether he will be or not, but I think he will. That's all for today's video, guys, and see you guys next time.